Hello and welcome to another tutorial from MoveICT. In this tutorial, we're going to be making a image animation effect using JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. Okay, so as you can see, this is what we're going to be making today. So I have a little cow image. That's basically just bumping from border to border on this image. So this is using something called HTML canvas to display the image or render the image and also to animate it inside. HTML canvases are very powerful and you can make a full game inside of HTML canvas with user interactivity, particle effects, and also a lot of some of the new multiplayer games are also made with JavaScript and HTML canvas. It's a really great resource to learn and you can quite easily embed this kind of stuff online so other people can play quite easily. So this is going to be our next step into the JavaScript game development progress overall. Since JavaScript language is quite similar to C#, it's going to be very easy for you to catch up with this one. Even if you're new to JavaScript, you can quite easily follow along with the tutorial as I'm going to go step by step with everything that we're going to be covering here. Okay, so to begin, I have these two images there that you might need to just download from the link in the description. All right, and I'm going to first copy these images. Let's make a new folder here called JavaScript canvas first tutorial. Okay, but just to keep it there, and I'm going to copy and paste this one here. Now with my Visual Studio Code loaded here, I'm going to drag and drop that folder here so that then becomes my workspace. Okay, update that later. Okay, so this is the grass image that we're going to be using and this is the cow image that we're going to be using. Right. I'm going to make a new file here called canvas first underscore canvas.html. Okay. So this file then gets created inside of the folder. So everything stays organized. Right. So if I open this one in Firefox, it's not there's nothing inside of it at the moment. Right, so just to start, we can do a explanation point and press tab in Visual Studio Code and it will just fill up the rest of the bits for us. So it has got all the tags and stuff that we need. We're not going to create a separate CSS file for this one because there's not much CSS needed. So we're going to just put the CSS that we need inside of the HTML. I'm going to give this one a title called Canvas First Project MoveICT. And then inside the body, okay, so inside the body, we can just go ahead and say H1. moving a sprite image using JS. MoveICT, like so. Okay, and then we also need to create the canvas itself. Okay, so the canvas is a HTML tag. Inside the canvas, we can give it a width of 550. We don't have to say px or pt or anything like that. Okay, and then a height of 400. Okay, and if I go and refresh that, so the canvas actually exists here right now because the background and the foreground are all the same. So we can't really see it. Okay, and this is where we're going to add a little bit of CSS just to differentiate a little bit. I'm going to go right under the title inside the head tag here. Style. Okay, inside of there, I'm going to type in body first. So for the body tag, I want everything to be aligned to the center. Okay, so the H1 and the canvas. And then for the canvas, I'm going to give it a background. All right, so background, we need to add the background URL. Okay, so URL here, and there is the grass.png. That needs to be inside a quotation mark. Okay, and I don't want that png to be repeating. Okay, so outside the bracket, there's no repeat. Okay, and now if I refresh this page, you can see that that shows up here quite nicely. Okay, and I'm going to say background size. I want it to cover the entire entire canvas. Okay, so we just set the background size to cover. Okay, and then now it's covering the entire size of the background. Oh, sorry, entire size of the canvas. Okay, and we also want to give it a border. Border is always nice. Border 2 pixels, solid black. Okay, there you go. So it's a nice border on there. Okay, so that's technically all we need for the HTML ones, and then we can jump right into the JavaScript. Okay, so I'm going to make some space here so I can work on my scripts. The script, all my JavaScript code is going to go inside of here. Okay, so canvases, as I said, is very, very powerful technology, and is this very useful, especially for beginner programmers, because we get to see what we are making and what's interacting and stuff like that. So especially, like, you know, adding images and stuff like this is quite exciting. What we can do is, 1 second. Okay, so inside the script, before we start, we're gonna basically create something called a JavaScript object. Let's go and find a JavaScript object. Okay, so a JavaScript object basically is a variable that you can pretty much put a lot of the properties inside of it, right? So here is an example of a car, right? And inside of the variable, you can also create these custom pointers inside of the variable that can kind of assign many values inside of it. So a car, this one here is a Fiat 500, color white, right? And we can do a similar thing with, say for the sprites, right? So we can create a sprite object that has a height with X and Y location inside of it. So that way we can control the sprite object, where it's moving to, and you know, where the X and Y value is going to be, what's the height and width is going to be, and you can put other values inside of it. So as we move forward with more tutorials, we're going to be looking at how to incorporate more of those so we can make more stuff with JavaScript. Okay, so let's go ahead and create our first sprite object. Okay, so we're going to say var, call it sprite object, is equals to, and now we need to do the curly bracket, and then it's end it with a semicolon as well. Okay, and in this one I'm gonna keep a comment to say say JavaScript object. So there's no such thing as a sprite object, but this is an object variable. Okay, but we're calling it sprite object because it makes sense in the context. Okay, so x 0, and after that we just do a comma y 0, but I do a comma as well, and then we go to width to say 64, because that's the size of the image that I want, and then height, we can also set that to 64 as well. Okay, and the last one doesn't need a comma because that's the last one. Okay, so any one before that will need a comma after it. Okay, and then after that we're gonna basically create some more stuff. So I think right before this one, I need to call my canvas. Okay, let's go and create the canvas here. So say var canvas is equals to document.query selector. No, query selector. I need to get the canvas inside of it here. So that's my canvas, right? And I also need to get the drawing surface. So I need to draw stuff onto the canvas, right? So call this one drawing surface is equals to canvas cancel animation canvas get context 2D. Okay, so that's our context here. Okay, so with these two done, so basically these are the very important ones that we need to communicate with the canvas in order to draw onto it. Okay, now let's go ahead and add our remaining variables. Okay, so I'm going to create a variable called moo, so that's the cat. Okay, let's say object o object.create. okay, and then we'll say sprite object. Okay, so that's the object is basically being created with the properties of this one. Okay, and also what we need to do is basically, because we're going to be loading an image and loading into the canvas, is better to add an event for load. So that way the load handling gets handled by the browser. So they, if there's any issues and stuff like that, they basically will load it first. That way there's no delay in loading the image. Okay, before we do that one, we need to set the mu.x. We should be able to access the x now to 100. Mu.y. 100. So basically we're placing the new object into the x value of 100 and a y value of 100, so it's a sort of like in the middle of the screen but not quite. Okay, let's create an image. My image is equal to new image. Okay, and this is where we need to add the event. Let's say add event listener. Okay, we're gonna go to load. So load is the event that we need. Load handler. And then we can set that must be to false. So okay, so that's the event that we're going to be creating in a bit. Okay, and then we say image.src is equals to moo.png, because that's the png file that's saved right here. Okay, all right, and this is going to be resized to 64 by 64. Okay, that's going to be a little bit differently later on. Okay, so now we need to create two variables that's going to control the speed of how fast the cow is moving in the x and y direction. Let's say var x speed equals to 2, var y speed is also equals to 2, right? And then var text, I'm just going to say hello moo, but that's the text that actually we can see on the screen there. Okay, so these are the variables that we need for this one. Then to move on, we can do a function here. So this is the event that's going to load the image. Okay, the load handler. Okay, no arguments needed here. And then we're basically just going to run the update function. So now let's do the update function here. Okay. So inside the update function, we're going to basically request the animation frame. So that way this function will then be running every frame the canvas is rendering, right? So what that does is then is that it creates a smooth animation for us. It's similar to how we used to use C# timers to create a animation loop, right? Or to create a sort of like a game loop. So by using this one, we're able to tick it through, right? With each frame that's changing, we can change the value of the image moving left, right, up, or down. Okay, so to do that, let me show you how this one works. So I'm going to call window, a request animation frame, and then we're going to run this function itself with the canvas. Okay, and then after that, now we can give the properties for the moo object and basically to check whether it's hitting left, right, up or down boundaries. And also then we need to create another function called render that's basically going to be rendering all the images and all the movements on the screen. Okay, so let's go to moo.x is going to be plus equals to x speed, moo.y plus equals to y speed, so that those two are then linked. Okay, and yeah, we can do some if statements. So if moo.width plus moo.x is greater than 550. So if the image has then reached end of the screen on the right, let's say x speed is equals to then 2. So x speed is equals to minus 2, sorry. Okay, so then it's going to reverse, right? And then we can also change the text here to say going left. Okay, we do another else if here. Hey, we do it, boy. Okay, let's do an else if here. Okay, after this if, let's say else if. Okay, another condition is moo.x, it now is less than 1. Okay, so you reach the left border. Okay, then we can switch the x speed equals to 2. So now it's going to be moving right. Okay, and then text is going to be going right. Okay, so these are for the left and right. Let's do it for the top and bottom. Okay, move dot height plus move dot y is greater than 400, so that's the bottom part. Then we've got y speed is equals 2 minus 2. And then I could have been an else if here, just for readability. Else if mu.y is less than 1, so that's the top. If you reach the top, then y speed is equals to 2. And text is going to be going down. That one, I forgot to add the text here. Going to be going up. Okay, so that's the left, right, up, and down. Okay, that works out great. Okay, and then right after this one, we're going to run the render function here. Okay, that's basically going to be rendering all of this, take all these properties, all this information, and then update it onto the frame. Okay, so let's get out of the update function. Let's do the render function here now. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to clear everything from the screen first, and then it's going to redraw it every frame. So that's how you're going to get the smooth animation. Okay, so drawing surface dot clear rect. Okay, and 0, 0, that's the location of everything that we want to clear. Height width as well, so canvas dot width, canvas dot height. Okay, so everything is cleared off from the screen, every frame. Okay, and then right after this, we're gonna say drawing surface dot draw image. Okay, draw image, do the different bracket here. Do the semicolon so we don't forget in the end. So here we're going to need to basically say what we're trying to draw. Okay, so we're drawing the image, okay, the image that's being loaded in. Okay, and then we're going to say math dot flow. Okay, so now we need to give the x and y value. Okay, so move dot x, and then math.flow again, mu.y. Okay, and right after the mu.y, we're going to say mu.height and then mu.width. Okay, so this is the benefit of using the object variable, is that everything sort of stays in, and also it's quite good when you have multiple objects moving around on the screen. You can move everything that you want using a for loop or a for each loop. Okay, so I think we have enough here to test it out for now. Can test it out and see. Oh, there we are. So right now it's actually going to be bumping up and down, and as soon as it hits that, it kind of goes and leaves the screen. Okay, let's find out what happened here. Smooth.y. Oh yeah, instead of y speed, I put them as a x speed. So that needs to be y speed here. Okay, let's test it out again. It should be working fine. There we are. Okay, so it's nicely staying inside the boundary of the canvas, and the frame rate is quite good. Alright, that's great. Next bit is we need to render the text. Okay, so inside the render function here, we can go to drawing surface dot font. Font is equals to bold 20 pixels Arial. So we have the Arial font for the text. Okay, and then we can say drawing surface dot fill text. The function. text, and then this is the location of the text file. So we need to give it X, Y, and a max width for it, right? So the text shouldn't go above that width. So 10 for X, 30 for Y, and then I want it to be like 200 pixels overall. So this can come quite handy if you wanna sort of limit the sort of space. If you have we all have limited space on the screen, so if your game needs to have limited space for the text, you can kind of do that, and then obviously it's gonna hide any of the overlapping elements from the text, right? And there's another way to test this to see how long is your text on the screen. So if you see now, it says "Hello Moo," and then as soon as it hits that, hits any of the borders, it changes the text. Okay, and so there's another way to check the width or the measure the width of the text, right? But to do that, let's go ahead and do a console.log. Okay. Drawing surface dot measure text, right? And then we're going to pass in the text here because that's the variable that we have there. Okay, and then we're going to say dot width. Okay, so the text, we want to make sure that we want to find out exactly how it's being drawn and what the width of it is. Okay, we're just going to refresh that. Press F12 here, and then you'll see that every time the text changes, the width is now being updated here. Okay, so far it's all being all staying inside of my 200 limit. And then the most it goes to 117. Okay, not bad. So this has been a quick tutorial on how to use a canvas, how to create a animation loop, and obviously how to make things bounce around while updating the text file and also changing some of the properties of the text file and so on. If you do need further help, the source code will be available on the website. Link is always in the description. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, please leave a like, subscribe, check out our members only page. I do update some of the courses that's only for members only. It's like a long form and fully completed courses, right? Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the next tutorial.